evening, peasants, and welcome back inside the castle grounds for another episode of Historia Mystoria. My name is Professor Sponseller, and I'm so glad that you've been able to join us once again as we dive deeper into the first settlements here in the New World. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Jamestown, the first settlement of Jamestown, which becomes the first permanent settlement in the New World. And so stay tuned and enjoy this episode as we dive into the first settlers here on Historia Mystoria. And today on Historia Mystoria, we are looking at the settlement of Jamestown. Yes, the one that probably is most well known. People, when they think of the first settlements in the New World, that they immediately think of Jamestown because of the story that's behind it. And so you might know the story a little bit. You might know the story of Pocahontas. You've probably watched the Disney movie. But we're going to really dive into it, both here in this lesson and also in class as we move forward. And so we're going to take a look at the year of 1607, the year that the settlement of Jamestown was created. Now, we know that the king in England and all of England was trying to become the best and biggest empire in the world. And the only way that they thought they could do this and to overtake the Spanish and the Portuguese was to get settlement in the New World. The issue was, every time that they've tried, it's failed. Look at Roanoke Island. It failed the first time. They tried it again. And now we don't know what happened to the second settlement. So they have yet to have any success in regards of creating a settlement here in the New World. But the Virginia Company, which is a company now kind of run by the church in England, by the king, is responsible for sending over this settlement, sending people over to try and put a permanent settlement here in the New World. Now, the problem was, just like before, two-thirds of the colonists in the first year had died of either disease or hunger. And so by now we understand that it's probably a really difficult thing for your body to come from the old world here to the new world and be able to survive, because a lot of the things that you bring over from the old world don't really do well here in the new world. And so that was going to be a major issue for these colonists as well. Well, the kingdom and the church wasn't going to give up easily. They knew that this was a must, that they actually had to get this done. And so what do? They send over Captain John Smith, a very burly military man who is going to be responsible for saving Jamestown. And here's how he does it. You know, he comes over with this attitude and says, there's got to be a reason why these people aren't surviving. And he realizes that these people were lazy. Yes, we think of Americans today, we're pretty lazy too. And these people had had everything handed to them. Probably in England, they had servants and maids and people to do things for them. But now that they're here in this new world with not all these things handed to them on a silver spoon, they didn't realize they had to work for this to actually be a successful colony. Of course, we all know the captain, John Smith, as we see it portrayed in the Disney movie, but that's not what he looks like. Of course, they portray him to be something magnificent, some beautiful hunk of a guy, but really he was this burly man, as you can see here. Now, how's he going to fix and save Jamestown? Well, the first thing he's going to do is bargain with the Indians. He understands that the food necessary to sustain life in this colony was going to have to be multiplied. And to do that, they were going to have food and learn how to grow certain things here by the neighboring Indians. And so he kind of gets in with the Powhatan Indians, which, of course, as we know, is where Pocahontas comes from. And we'll get back to that in just a few minutes. But this is the biggest one. He calls for a no-work, no-food rule, meaning he pretty much told the colonists, if you don't work, then you're not going to eat. Therefore, you're going to starve, you're going to die, and I could care less. That's what he said, because he said, look, you can't expect to be a successful colony if you do not work. And so his big thing was that you had to work. The second thing was he knew that they needed to model their whole colony or their little village much better than that of Roanoke Island or something that they had done before. And as you can see here in a model of a picture of Jamestown, you can see that it looks a whole lot better You've got the homes or the little huts that you live in on the outside. You've probably got the communal building there in the middle, the meeting place, a nice big open area where they could meet in the middle to dish out chores and do things like that. I'm sure the mess hall was there as well. And you can see that they have outlooks and they've got a better fence, something to keep away certain maybe tribal Indians who were disliking the fact that these white men were over here, or maybe even wild animals. And so you can see that this one is much better constructed than that we kind of saw in the Roanoke Island episode here on Historia. Now moving on, another John. Yes, here we go, right? We've had John Smith, we've had John White, and now we've got John Rolfe. And John Rolfe is the man who marries the Powhatan Princess Pocahontas. And if you know the story, it was kind of controversial because we know that Pocahontas's dad was the chief of the Powhatans. He was not happy when he found out this news. As a matter of fact, he tries to kill John Rolfe, and of course we know that the ending story if you've ever watched Pocahontas. But this is what Pocahontas is portrayed as in the Disney movie. But when I show you this picture, that's not what she really looked like. Of course, they had a movie come out about it not too long ago. It wasn't a great movie. I don't recommend it. However, you can see what they portray Pocahontas as here. But the real Pocahontas looks like this. Now, Pocahontas obviously was kind of integrated into the English way of life once she left the New World, went back to the Old World with John Rolfe, and kind of became an English subject. And so you see here with the powder white face, it really doesn't look like an Indian at all, but that is what Pocahontas looked like after she was kind of integrated into the English way of life. Of course, here's John Rolfe and what they portray him as in the Disney film. This is what they do in the actual Hollywood film. And then, of course, you've got the real John Rolfe, which actually looks nothing like those that we just saw prior to that. Now, how did Pocahontas become such a major player in American history? Because we all know her. I mean, we memorialize her and on coins and certain things like that. So she is an American hero. But how? Because what did she do? She would have had to have done something. She just didn't marry somebody here that came here and then went away. No, she actually is going to be responsible for saving Jamestown. So if you ever are asked who saved Jamestown, okay, yes, John Smith, but it was really, really Pocahontas and what she kind of gave to these colonists to help them survive. And what was that? Simply, tobacco. Yes, tobacco. We know that the Indians have been growing it forever, that they enjoyed it. And the whole tobacco plant, when they realized you could dry it and smoke it and use it for other things as well, like wrapping meats and things up in it and cooking them in it. There were many different uses for tobacco that we don't think about today. But how in the world can this save Jamestown, you ask? Simple. Because what doesn't grow in England? Tobacco. And because of that, they can send this tobacco back to the Old World. It can catch on with all the elite and with all the people living in England. And it's going to be a mass production and a big, huge money grabber for the New World. And so this plant, the tobacco plant, was able to sustain life for those who were there, and they all became tobacco farmers. And so when John Rolfe was introduced to this by Pocahontas, of course, we know that the tobacco plant became the savior, all right, for Jamestown. And so Jamestown, with the help of John Smith and Pocahontas, is going to survive and become the first permanent settlement here in the New World. And so yet another mystery solved here on Historia Mystoria. And if we take a look and review exactly what did we learn today. Number one, that, you know, the first settlement of Jamestown, the first few people here, over two-thirds of them had died by the end of the first year. We know that, number two, England sent over John Smith to try and save Jamestown by bargaining with the Powhatan Indians and setting up a no-work, no-food policy for those lazy people working in the colony. And then number three, we know that Pocahontas was able to marry John Rolfe and also introduce them to the savior known as tobacco, which was going to allow them to become the first permanent settlement in the New World. Well, that'll wrap up this edition of Historia Mystoria. I thank you for watching once again. Until you have to tune in once again to Historia Mastoria or another one of my great videos, always remember, the more that you are involved, the more that you will learn. And as always, beware of the dungeons. Good night.